Assalamu alaikum. So today I am going to create another Terraform video, and I will be using ansible from this Terraform file. So let's get started. Let's do in some create some directory. So first of all, let's add some variables.tf. So first of the variable we should use is region. Default US East 1. Let's give it some description. Resources. Okay. Another one we would use some SSH key pair. So some SSH key pair, give it a name, description, key pair name, and we would name it my SSH key. Key pair name, my SSH key. And another one, the public file. I would use my, oh my god, I would use my default SSH key which I am I have already created. So let's give its path. SSH ID dot public. So yeah, and yeah, we would use some AMI, so give it some variable image ID. Default, I have already created it. So yeah, variables are defined. So let's write our main.tf file. So first of all, use the provider AWS, and region where dot region. Yeah, here you can see variables dot tf. Let's format it so it looks beautiful. So Terraform. It, as you can see now, it looks beautiful. So main.tf, and then we create create a resource for our SSH key. AWS SSH key. Key name is where and SSH key pair name. Yeah, let me check if this was the variable SSH key pair name. Okay, yeah, key pair name. Public key is where SSH key pair public. Key pair ka public. Okay. So let's create another resource for Amazon EC2 instance. So first of all, we would use the AMI, the image ID, so that's already defined in the variable. So var.ami and instance type is t2.micro. Let's move this one to the variables. Create a new variable. EC2 type. So yeah, and which key name we want to attach to it? I think it should be like no, I have not defined it in the variable. Actually, we have to use this key. So AWS SSH key dot, actually I have not defined some name here, so on my EC2 and here my SSH key. So SSH key and then this key name dot my SSH key and then the key name. So that's it. Actually, we have I want to specify a local provisioner inside this EC2, so just run provisioner local-exec. should be like we have to wait for 30 seconds before this EC2 is up and able to connect back. So sleep 30 and then the ansible playbook command, playbook and even but the actually the host where we want to run it. So we want to get the IP from this EC2 instance dot my EC2 dot public IP. So it will fetch this EC2 public IP here and make sure to add comma here, so ansible will assume that it is a target host. And let's put some environment variables. So because in my ansible playbook I have configured it there as target host. Target host would be same just like above. AWS instance dot my EC2 dot public IP. Yeah, and then we have to specify the user. Yeah, user this is the Debian AMI which I am using. So as the new AMI, as the new instance is launched, you already have a sudo user which is admin. So and then we will give it the playbook. So I am going to use ansible directory for the playbook and then playbook.yaml. okay, so that's it. Yes, so let's create the playbook directory ansible, and I already have defined one. I have created a ansible playbook ansible, and yeah, here you can see this is the playbook which I am going to use. What it does, it actually creates a new user AK and give it to the add it to the sudo group, and if Z shell is not installed, it install the Z shell and give it a password which is hashed, and this is the username AK, and this is the gcos and shell and groups, and add my public SSH key to this user authorized key so I can SSH to it. So yeah, it's okay. So Terraform plane, we have not run the Terraform init inside this directory, so let's do that. It will take some time because it will fetch the required provider right now. It is inst installing the AWS module. Yeah, now you can see it has installed the AWS provider, so Terraform plan. There is some error. SSH key pair, I think it is called key pair. Main.tf, I got some error. Let's check the documentation for the key pair. I actually have forgotten. AWS SSH key and pair, same thing here. You can see this key pair will be created and is the EC2 instance which will be created, and then the Ansible playbook will be executed. So Terraform apply yes. It is giving me error, so let's give it some key contents. So variables, contacts there, so run Terraform apply. Now it is going to create. Actually my SSH key has been created. Now it is going to create the EC2. It will create this EC2 and then run the local exec provisioner. Creation EC2 has been created, and now it is running the local exec provisioner. And here you can see I have give it command like sleep for 30 seconds, so the EC2 will be available. Yes, I want to connect. So now it is running the local exec provisioner. It is doing the first task like updating the apt cache. So this is the IP of the new EC2 created. Now it is checking if Z shell is installed. So it was not installed. It will now install the Z shell. The Z shell is installed. Now it is checking if there is a user AK. So there was no user, so now it will create the AK user. And the last task, now adding my SSH public key to authorized key. cookies. So yeah, here you can see two resources added. The playbook was okay, like I have not got some error from the playbook as well. So this is the IP of new EC2 created, so let's connect to it. SSH, okay, and then give it the newly created IP. As you can see, I am on this IP and it used my SSH key which I mentioned. So let's destroy the resources now. It's a good practice to destroy the created resources if you don't want to use them. Destroying the SSH key and then destroying the EC2. Yes. So yeah, the task is completed. I have destroyed all those resources created. So that's it. Thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video. Bye bye.